guys excited to know that I'm recording?
I'm so excited. Brain.
What?
Okay, here we go. Welcome to Nerd Play. I'm Dan, and with me as always are...
Jason.
And Brandon.
That was solid, guys. That was like absolutely the most solid one we've ever done. We're getting a lot better.
Mm-hmm. I'm perfect every week.
Shut up. Nobody cares, Dan. Fuck off.
Get on with it. What are you doing?
Golly, you guys are mean. So it's like a pretty slow week, right? Does it feel like anything exciting has happened this week, really?
I'm quitting my job.
There definitely wasn't a huge trade show in Japan. That's for
that
sure.
Never happened.
Oh yeah,
that
Tokyo. Never happened. Is it just me, or was there not very much coverage of TGS like anywhere?
Nowhere. There was no coverage. I couldn't find it.
The only thing,
nobody cared.
The only thing I saw from TGS was 15 minutes of Metal Gear Survive. And by saw 15 minutes of, I mean saw 2 minutes of, and then said, what the fuck am I doing? And turned it off.
Step one. Solid choice. Step one, watch Metal Gear Survive. Step two, reevaluate life.
Yeah. What it was pretty good about it, though, I was surprised by this anyway, is that it wasn't like... The gameplay in it wasn't like just like Left 4 Dead shit, which is what I expected. It's just gonna be running and gunning.
Right.
They were actually like sneaking around and stabbing him in the back and shit. And I was like, that might be fun if the game was like $10, but you know it's gonna be like $60 or some shit.
Right. So it's like Resident Evil, but with stealth tactics.
No, because it also has better camera controls, better combat controls, better everything controls, because it's still based on the Fox engine from Metal Gear Solid 5. And if you haven't played Metal Gear Solid 5, you absolutely should, because it's one of the best games ever made, in my opinion.
It really is amazing.
Have you played it?
I have played it.
I'm actually pretty certain it's not a $60 game.
Is maybe it like $49.99?
I could see it being $40 like ReCore, and then but no, mm-hmm. Still no one would buy it.
Right.
I could see. And I don't think anyone would buy it before it was a $20, honestly.
They're going to try and... I'm sure they're going to try and do some free-to-play. Sell some something.
Go
in
Konami.
Like they do with 5.
The way it'll work is that if you... you can win a copy of the game by playing the Metal Gear Solid pachinko machines.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it's going to work.
Wheel one into my house. I'll play it all day long.
Dude, have you seen them, though? I mean, pachinko's stupid, but the machines are cool. They have, like... HD versions of the cutscenes from Metal Gear Solid 3, which is like the best Metal Gear Solid game.
Agreed.
So Jason and I have both been playing some new games this week. I have been playing ReCore, which is from Concept, right? Is that how you say it? Concept? And who the fuck's the other company? I forgot
ReCore?
The name of it. Yeah, it's not retro, but it like was retro at one point.
I'll tell you.
I have no idea.
Figure it out.
Will you, Jason?
Don't you guys fucking have internet right now? How are we talking? You can't look this up?
I have... My hands are busy holding on to an old stylus tip, and...
You know what happened? You know what, Dan? You use a stylus, you're fucking dead.
Well?
Armature...
Yeah, what are you, iPad Pro user?
Yeah, I'm like one of three in the whole world. I saw an iPad Pro on the train once.
Listen to me. It's Armature Studios and Concept.
Yeah, Concept. Oh, yeah, new Concept. So Concept is the guy, is what's his face, the guy who made Mega Man, who quote unquote made Mega Man, and then Armature or the like leftovers from Retro, the guys who made Metroid Prime.
And then they came together and made a beautiful baby.
Yeah, here's the thing, right? So Jason's seen some of the game because I have been streaming almost my whole playthrough of it. Brandon hasn't seen any of it because he doesn't give a fuck.
Brandon is just going to... I feel like Brandon is just going to remove himself as much as he can from this game just so he can continue to say it's bad.
Yeah. It's like Jason's like... Or Brandon's like, watch someone play a game. That's fucking stupid. I'm not going to do that. Now if you'll excuse me, I have to go watch basketball.
That's partially right. Basketball season is a couple months away still. So
I was just pointing out foosball, yeah. I was just pointing out the irony in the fact that you can watch those guys play a game. but not a pro tier MLG level fucking ReCore player like me. Anyway, yeah, the game's been getting like, it's like sitting around like sixes and sevens for the most part in reviews. And I don't.
It's great for the first, what, 6 hours?
I'm wondering if it's even that long.
Is it?
The thing is, like, I haven't gotten to the point yet where the combat feels bleh, you know? Mm-hmm. And, like, a lot of the things that people are citing as negatives were, like, when I was talking to Jason, they were the things I was citing as positives. Like, I feel like it feels reminiscent of a different era, you know? Like, it reminds me of, like, Jax and Daxter or fucking Ratchet and Clank or just old, like, PS2 fucking GameCube era.
Early 2000s.
Yeah, like, run and gun platformer adventure game, you know? And I'm having a blast with it. You know, I think it's a lot of fun to play. The combat, oh my god, it's so funny. So there was like this video that Polygon released, and it was like 15 minutes of ReCore, and there was all these comments like, holy shit, the enemies are bullet sponges, blah, blah, blah. You know, talking about how like, how the person had to shoot them so many times before they died and shit like that. I played their entire 15-minute segment in about 5 minutes.
I watched you do it, and none of those enemies looked like bullet sponges whatsoever. Yeah. They actually, the only thing I can think is that if they previously got like a press version of the game or like a specific version that you couldn't actually, wasn't released to the public, maybe it was different in there. I don't know.
No. The review version was the exact same version because it was all these stories about how there wasn't going to be a day one patch for load times. Because that was the day one version that they had or something. And you know what it is? I mean, did you see Polygon play Doom?
Mm-mm.
No.
They were fucking awful at it. Like, they got... they, like, were so taking damage in the first room of the game. Against the enemies that you can...
Basically, what you're saying is get good, Polygon.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing. Is like, shit like that was giving the game, like, this rep of having, like, bullet spongy enemies. But it's just like, they just fucking don't know how to play video games there. It's like, if a game has controls more complex than The Witness, they're like, what the fuck do I do? I gotta press a button to jump and a different button to shoot? What the fuck? It's 2016!
I really hope Arthur Geese never listens to this, because he will be very disappointed.
He's gonna post our only thumbs down. He's our only thumbs down for the last episode.
They're gonna get like a super scathing tweet, like... You know, about how we are, like, just fucking mansplaining video game mechanics to people.
Oh, hey, did you guys see we got a positive comment on a review on YouTube? I won't cut off your ReCore, though, because we'll segue into that next.
Did we really?
We did. Did you see that? But I'll talk more about that later.
We got nothing but negative feedback for our episode about, what was it? Americans know nothing about World War
World War One. Yeah.
Nothing but negative feedback. But
awesome.
But so the game is actually a lot of fun. Here's the catch. Here's the whatever. You know, I don't know what the phrase I'm looking for is, but it's a play anywhere game. And I wanted to stream it. I don't have a capture box yet. And even if I did, the Xbox is in the other room. I don't feel like moving it. But I was playing it on PC. On PC, the load times are short. The game runs super smooth. You know, no frame rate hiccups, nothing.
Do you have an SSD?
Yeah, but it's not on the SSD. It's all my games are on a normal hard disk drive.
You would just use an SSD to boot.
I use the SSD for Windows, for Photoshop. I use it for Star Citizen because Star Citizen has notoriously long load times.
That makes sense.
But I mean, it's only 500 gigabytes, so I don't put too much shit on it. You know, I do want to get like another 500 gigabyte one, I think maybe just for games, and then use the other one mainly for movies and stuff. But anyway, I tried playing it on the Xbox the other day, you know, and because I was like, I'm just going to run around. They have like these challenge dungeons where you basically try to shoot 8 switches, beat the dungeon in like so many, in like a time limit, and find this yellow key all at the same time. And I was trying to just knock a few of those out because you collect these things called prismatic orbs. That's how you unlock new areas and stuff like that. And doing these dungeons, you get 2 prismatic orbs, and then you get like upgrade parts for your robots because you can have, they have different frames, like the dog frame, the spider frame, the Harambot frame, which is like a gorilla, in case you didn't get my little joke. The flyer frame. And there's at least another one. I don't know what the hell it is yet because I haven't gotten it. But you can upgrade those to have better parts. Like, and when you get all three, you get like actually like rare parts or good parts. Like when Jason was watching, I got a part for the spider bot that made him wear Wayfarer sunglasses and a beanie cap on top of his head.
It was pretty badass.
It was so funny. But anyway, yeah, I was doing Challenge Dungeons. I was playing it on the Xbox, and the load times are fucking awful. Like, they are really fucking slow. And since this game was, you know, advertised as an Xbox One game, not as a PC game, that's going to be, like, the primary audience. So that is the one thing I could see people complaining about. Because, holy fuck, the load times are just ridiculous on the console. They just take for fucking ever. And, like, every time you die, you have to reload the area. So it just takes... It's painful, you know? That aside, though, the gameplay is super fun. The world is super cool. There's, like, very little story. It's a $40 game. Like, when you're playing
it's very pretty, too. I was watching you play it, and it is a very pretty game. I like it a lot.
Yeah, the combat is fast-paced. Not like, you know, fucking Devil May Cry fast-paced or something like that. But, I mean, like, you have to pay attention to what you're doing. Like, there's so many times that I'm, like, pointing at nothing. Like, what the fuck? Where am I looking? What happened? You know? So that's, like, something you have to keep in mind when you're playing it. Like, you have to, like, you know, constantly be aware. What is it called? Situational awareness.
Yes,
that's a key part of the game. And there's so much exploring, like just shit to find if you look around. You know, it's a lot of fun. Honestly, I don't know how far I am in it. The main bad guy they showed in the beginning of the game, I like already killed him once. So, and now I'm going through like some tower where you have to go up a floor at a time of like 7 floors.
Oh no, I feel like you're explaining Star Ocean to me, and it's giving me flashbacks.
I feel like I'm in Wily's castle. It's how it feels. But it feels like I'm there really soon.
Like it's happening. It's all happening too fast.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe I've just been playing it longer than I thought I have. But either way, I like the game a lot so far. And, you know, I think it's probably not going to be $40 for long. I bet it'll go down to $30. And... honestly, if you have an Xbox One and also if you have gray hair, you should buy this game.
You just told me the load times are unbearable.
Fuck it. They'll patch it. Just get it. It's fun.
Well, why don't I just wait until they patch it then?
Maybe that's when it will go to $30.
Well, there you go.
Also, it came with Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, which I'll probably never, ever install.
Man, I wish I could play Banjo-Kazooie. Yeah, my wife, that's like one of the only franchises she really likes is the Banjo-Kazooie.
Well, then don't
franchise.
Let her play Nuts and Bolts, because then she won't like
it. Is it bad? Is it that bad?
Oh, that game's fun.
Thank Actually, you, I might install it just because I want to make like one of those plank cars that you make in the beginning.
I mean, it's nothing like the actual Banjo-Kazooie game, so...
Is it like a Crash Nitro?
It's like, it's called... Banjo Pooey is what they call it.
No, that's not what they call it. It's all about designing vehicles and exploring the world with those.
Well, it,
but it's got pretty good physics.
Does it? So I'll give it a shot. I mean, it was free. It came with the game.
So is it kind of like Diddy Kong Racing then? How like you have to go around all those different areas before you get into like a match?
Sort of. Okay. Sort of, except there's. I don't think
well,
there's
it's an adventure
real
game.
Racing.
Yeah, it's like an adventure game, not a racing game.
Okay.
Can you guys hear?
He's talking about. Oh, never mind.
Sorry. Can you guys hear TV in the background from my mic?
No. Can you hear TV in the background from my mic?
No. I just wanted to make sure because I can hear what Kayla's watching, and I just want to make sure you guys couldn't.
No. Okay. Good. Kate right. usually watches TV when we do this, and you guys can never hear it.
She's so rude. Kate is so fucking rude. Spit off the balcony on her.
I will not.
Oh, Brandon, what were you going to say?
I thought about it, but I won't.
I just said he was talking about the free roam area of Diddy Kong. So that's kind of the similar, I guess. I don't know.
I never played Diddy Kong Racing. I was like, what is this fucking cheap bullshit? Get the fuck out of here. This ain't no Mario Kart shit. Get the fuck out of here.
It was really good.
Yeah, but who gives a fuck about Donkey Kong characters? Is it as good as Super Mario or Super Sonic the Hedgehog All-Star Sega Racing?
No.
Sonic All-Stars. That's what it's called. And it's fucking good. All right. So, Jason, you... anyway, there'll be a review for ReCore probably sometime this week. I just
No, say it like that. Say it like you were going to say it.
There'll be a review for ReCore at some point this week. Just not yet. Jason, you played... you did a review this week of a game.
I did a review for a game, and it was another Tiny Build Association, and it was put out by a company called
Sunday. Hold on a second. Tiny Build Association? Is that what you're
getting? Yeah, it was associated with Tiny Build.
Fair enough.
Tiny Build. I'm not saying that the Tiny Build Association. No, I'm saying it was associated with Tiny Build, but it wasn't created by Tiny Build. It was just kind of produced by them. Sunday Month actually developed this game and created it. And it's called Diaries of a Spaceport Janitor. I fucking hated it when I first started playing it. I absolutely did not like it. It started off, okay, I'll say this. It started off with a lot of bright colors, and I felt like I was playing like a Tamagotchi and in like a 3D playpen, I guess you describe it. Okay. But then things just got really, really too weird for me and too aimless and directionless, and I couldn't do anything. I didn't know what to do. So after I realized that, okay, that's kind of the point of the game is you're not supposed
to
know what
to do. That's absolutely
really.
The point of the game, actually.
Right. You're not supposed to know what to do. And I realized the more you just go around and wander around aimlessly, you will eventually find direction. And it did. It happened. And one of the coolest things about this game is the fact that there's several dynamics to it. There's a dynamic of you walk around, pick up trash, burn the trash, and get money. Mm-hmm. And then there's this dynamic of, oh, you can also go into dungeons. But in order to go into a dungeon, you have to eat an object that puts you into like a first-person view. And when you're in that first-person view, it looks like you're in some sort of weird drug-induced state where there's a bunch of weird colors around you, like you should be wearing those old-school 3D glasses with the red and blue lenses. So... And then you can explore dungeons when you eat that, I guess. And one of the object itself is like an eye. It's called the Eye of Beb. And Beb is one of these nine goddesses you can worship. Describing this game makes me sound like a fucking crazy person. Like if I were to sit down. Okay, here we go. Here we go. I'll just do it right now. Okay, so you're a janitor on a spaceport, right? And you eat these eyes that are from like a goddess. And there's nine different goddesses that you can choose from. Mm-hmm. Oh, and you got to go around and you burn trash. So you burn trash and you get money. And the only way to get the money is in the morning when you wake up in your apartment, you got to pray to your god. Then the god gives you money. Oh, yeah, by the way, maybe you're going to get attacked by a skull when you go into a dungeon and it's going to curse you and follow you around for a bunch of, the rest of your life until you can figure out how to get rid of it. And the only way to get rid of it is to get these three pieces of a stone tablet. And good luck figuring out how the fuck you get that stone tablet. That's the game.
Honestly, that sounds really fun. I want to play it.
You should play it. I say give it a whirl. It wasn't necessarily for me. I might go back to it. I can't see myself like I don't think about it that much when I'm not playing it. When I'm immersed in it, it's okay. I'm like, all right, this is kind of cool. I like this, whatever. But I don't feel like I sit around thinking about it like I do some games. Like some games I'll sit around and think about like, what was I missing that last time I played that game?
ESO.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect example. I sit around thinking about ESO a lot. I don't sit around thinking about Diaries of a Spaceport Janitor.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Okay. So what is the point to the game? Like what's the, is there an end to the game?
To be a janitor.
Can you beat it?
The end or the supposed end is your goal is to get off of the spaceport or the trash planet that you are on.
Oh, so it takes place on Earth.
Okay.
Yeah, basically. And the whole setup is like this weird spaceport that looks like a Moroccan bazaar, but it's got a weird like Adventure Time Animal Crossing feel to it.
Is this a game about India?
No.
Where they worship multiple goddesses and you have to clean up garbage and burn it?
Wait a minute. You might be right. Actually.
You're on to something.
I was under the speculation that Sunday month just basically made a parallel of everybody's regular life. Like, you do a bunch of tedious shit all day long, and really, in the end, it doesn't pay off.
Speak for your fucking self, dude. I BMX biked to work today, had to jump 3 fucking bridges. You know, I then for lunch, I went base jumping off of a skyscraper and crash landed on the in the garden area of a very nice restaurant where they gave me food for free because they thought I was such a radical, intense, extreme dude.
That is really, really cool. And you live a very, very charmed life. And
then I burned garbage.
That's pretty much my life. If I could sum up my life in like one phrase, it's burning garbage.
You know what? I'm sure your cooking's better than that.
Yeah, you're right. It is. It is a lot better than that. No, but I mean, if you want to get this game, like I'd say give it a whirl. Like I said, it's not going to be for everybody. So if you can find a demo of it and play it just to get a feel for it, I'd do that first. But really,
I know this really good demo website, actually.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, it's called the Pirate Bay.
Probably shouldn't broadcast that.
Hey, man, you don't want us to pirate your games? Didn't make demos.
Yeah,
it's very true.
That makes sense.
Or if you want to get a feel for the game, you can always watch my review on it as well.
Yeah.
I'll give you a great feel for the game.
Watch and Twitch. Actually,
watch Twitch, because I will stream there it eventually too. But someone gave us our first positive review. And let me just tell you the name of this person.
I saw
Hentai
it.
Money.
Hentai Money! It was a good comment too. It said,
it was.
Nice review.
Thanks. It was like this review is very helpful. Thank you. And I feel like it was very helpful. I feel like it really encompassed everything
which
the game
is funny
because
you like phoned it in so hard compared to your last. You're like, yeah, it's a game, but you're like on a planet. You're like, I don't know, burn garbage. It's a Starbucks monster, though. It's scary.
What do you mean I phoned it in?
I'm saying it was
It
was much more off the cuff than your review of Valhalla, let's put it that way.
Yeah. It literally was off the cuff because my original review I wrote for it was very negative. I only gave it a 2 and I actually bumped it up to 3 when I tried the game again to give it another whirl.
On the recommendation of a brilliant friend of yours.
It was a brilliant recommendation because I was like, you know what, maybe that smart guy Dan Crum is right and maybe I should give it another spin as to not look like a jackass when people listen to my review and go, what the fuck is this idiot talking about? So I'm glad I did that because, yeah, I think it turned out really well. But because I didn't have time to write another review, I just literally sat down in front of the microphone and just was like, well, whatever. Here's what's happening in this game.
Why are you laughing so hard?
What?
Why are you laughing?
Because it was... I don't know. Why shouldn't I be laughing?
Cracking up. It was just funny.
I thought it was hilarious that I didn't prepare for it.
I thought it came out pretty good, though. It was like that one video we did for the bowling alley.
Hey, come on to the Lost Mine. No. We right. got bowling.
No. Come on. Let's go bowling.
Nobody knows what you're talking about.
Everybody go on Dan's YouTube page and watch this video because I'm sure he links to it.
No, I don't.
You don't?
I don't even know. Where the fuck would I link to it? From where?
Guess what? Nerdplay is tweeting it out.
That's cool.
Get ready, world.
Oh my god.
Thank you.
That's crazy.
It doesn't work when you don't talk. I can't read.
You couldn't see it in the little corner?
It's too far away.
I actually want to start doing this where we have all 3 of our cameras on so people can see Brandon's faces he makes.
Are we live streaming this right now?
No. Because if we were, it'd just be a picture of the Nerdplay logo in front of some stripes. And also, I'd have been like, hold on, let me play this dope fucking intro I'm working on. It's coming
Stay tuned
along.
For that.
It's coming
it looks
along.
Good. Did you watch it, Brandon?
No.
What a fucking asshole.
Come on, dude.
I like how he doesn't even like fucking hesitate to be like, nah, I said fuck it.
Did you watch my review?
No, but I you know, you actually sold me on it. I'm gonna watch it after we're done. Maybe I should watch it, now. I don't know.
I don't even want you to.
Well, don't watch it
right
now.
You have to block me.
So, Jason,
that on YouTube, right?
You're banned. You're banned from NerdPlay's YouTube channel, Brandon.
Jason, you said you read an interesting article today, right?
Oh, I did read an interesting article today. I read an interesting article that said that Android users actually have better humility and humanity than iOS users. What do you boys think about that?
Everyone I've met who has an iPhone is a douchebag piece of shit. That includes Brandon's wife and my girlfriend.
And jeez. My wife.
And your wife.
Great.
I just think, I don't know. I think iPhone users are clearly either you've been an Apple fanboy forever or you needed something that you could work with little to no effort.
I feel
those
like
those are the only two reasons you have an iPhone.
I feel like the because you want to look cool.
Wow.
Like people wanted to look cool when the iPhone first came out, and now they're stuck in the iPhone environment. You know, they're stuck with iOS because all their shit, the ecosystem, because all their shit's in there. I feel like it's a fucking, I don't even know how you would measure that. Android's 80 or 90% of the fucking smartphone market?
Right.
It seems like it'd be a skewed fucking study.
I'm assuming it was pretty skewed, but it was done by the university.
By a bunch of Android users?
Yeah, probably. It was done by the University of Lincoln. Where's the link? Where's the link that I sent you to that article I read?
I don't know. In our chat. In our
NerdPlay
chat.
Little secret that you guys might not know. Most university studies are a small sample size.
Yeah, it was only that's what I'm saying. It was only 240 people. So, not a huge portion of people, but I also just found an article claiming that iPhone users have more sex than Android users.
Absolutely true.
Absolutely.
Because Android users are big fucking nerds. Loser nerds who are kissless virgins.
In my relationship, it's one-to-one.
Right. Not with me and Kayla. I have way more sex than she does.
Oh, you better say that a little quieter.
That was a joke, of course. But no, I can see that. But I think more iPhone users are going to the bar and then dropping their iPhone and cracking the screen.
True.
And the people who go to the bar are the people who are probably going to have sex more than the people who stay at home and are trying to level up their druid so they can do a raid with their fucking, guildmates.
This is crazy scientific.
What I'm doing right now? Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It is crazy scientific.
I'm basically the fucking Albert Einstein of, off-the-cuff fucking judgments about people based on what kind of phone they use.
Specifically their sex lives.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, just in general. But, yeah, I don't know. What do you think, fucking Jason, throwing this question at us and not even giving us your fucking opinion?
I want you guys to talk about it too before I interject. I honestly think it's kind of a bunch of bullshit if you really get down to it, because I used to have an iPhone, right? Mm-hmm. And then I got an Android device, and I do like Android a lot better than iPhone, but that's because I am a fucking nerd and I like doing that weird stuff that you can do with your phone, and I like customization, and I like to be able to download third-party apps onto my phone with ease and not have to find some weird go between reach around method.
Reach around? You're using your phone wrong.
I know. I am using my phone wrong. See, and that is why iPhone users have more sex, because Android users just use their phones to have sex.
You can't reach around with the iPhone anymore. There's no headphone jack. Your finger has to be lightning adaptable or whatever. Have a lightning adapter before you can reach around with an iPhone now.
Oh, brilliant. Brilliant. But yeah, I don't know. I think it's kind of bullshit, and I think it's skewed, and I think it's funny to think about because you always have those snap judgments about people when you see them you know, in their, yeah, their hipster sunglasses and sport coats and t-shirts, pulling out their iPhones.
Yeah, with like their Pop-Tart iPhone case.
Right. With their Nyan Cat iPhone case.
Did you say Nyan?
How do you say it?
Nyan Cat.
Nyan?
Nyan.
Nyan.
Like Nyan. Anyway,
isn't that what I said?
And Gadget posted a you said Nyan.
Nyan?
Mm.
Nyan?
Nyan Cat.
Nyan Cat.
Nyan Cat?
And Gadget posted a review of the iPods or the AirPods or the AirBuds.
The AirBuds, yeah.
And they were like, don't buy them. Which I thought was like pretty funny, honestly.
Is that like, what they said?
Yeah, they don't said, they're like, look, it's $160. The quality is no better than the $10 earbuds that come with the iPod, with the iPhone. And they are clunky and not good looking, and just don't fucking buy them. Just wait till next generation, and they'll probably be better.
You think you know more about...
You think you know more about AirPods?
AirPods, don't fucking buy them.
You know what they should do is just make them look like the things from Her.
Yeah. You know? Why didn't they do that? Wow, they missed the fucking boat, for real. Right?
They could have sold those and then pants that come up to your nipples. And people would have gone crazy for it.
And fake mustaches.
Brandon's obviously never seen Her.
I haven't. I started to watch it one time. And
it's a real good, it's good, but it's melancholy. If you are one who can give in, if you can like, if you like are one of those people who like, are super empathetic and like adapt to other people's emotions by being around them.
Don't watch this
don't
movie.
Don't really watch
you
it.
You will break down. Yeah. You will break down.
No, that's but Brandon's like the opposite a sociopath. Of me, so.
Yeah, Brandon is got no fucking emotion.
Not really.
He traded it in for an upgrade in I forgot the name of it. That horrible PS3 game that you, me, and Sean played where you like had mechs and shit and it took place in outer space and it was like a sequel to that airplane fighting game, like War, whatever. Or...
Oh, nope. Lost it.
Good.
Air Guys?
I played that?
Yeah, it was a free-to-play game, or like the demo was, and then you had to buy it after that, I think. PS3 exclusive. You like...
I don't think I ever played that game.
It was like an RTS and FPS at the same time.
Oh, yeah. Are
we going to talk about anything relevant?
Hawken? No.
No, but it's like...
Stephen Hawking.
Warhawk was the prequel.
Yeah. Scott...
Wing Commander.
Yeah, that's it. It was Wing Commander. Jason, you're a fuck... It's Starhawk. And Jason is a dumb son of a bitch. Speaking of Wing Commander,
man,
you know,
we should play
you know
it.
Oh yeah, let me just go find a PS3. I'm sure there's one in a garbage can around here somewhere.
Dude, I've still got mine hooked up.
Same.
I threw mine away. And I threw
How
away,
else am I supposed
I mean,
to play 3D
it.
Movies?
Oh my god. You're not. God damn it. I was going to talk about something, but then you said 3D movies and just totally...
And that's all we need to talk
about.
Oh,
I was going to say, speaking of Wing Commander, you know, in a couple weeks now, it's like on August 9th? Something like that. I think it's the 9th. CitizenCon.
So it's like...
Or October. October 9th.
3 weeks ago.
Star Citizen Convention?
Yeah, CitizenCon. Star Citizen Convention is a weird way
what,
to put it. It's
a
more like.
Convention already?
Already?
The game isn't even. Doesn't exist
I don't,
yet.
They've had it for like 3
I don't
years.
Like CitizenCon. I don't like saying CitizenCon because it sounds like someone's trying to say Citizen Kane, and I hate it. I hate. I don't hate that movie, but I hate.
You hate Citizen Kane? Oh.
I just said I don't hate that movie.
Well, I was a little behind.
Brandon hates Citizen Kane.
Yeah.
He's like,
I don't like it because
take your deep
like
focus
that.
And shove it down your fucking throat, you piece of shit.
Fuck off, Orson Welles.
No, I hate Citizen Kane.
Me too.
Are you guys talking about your communist comrade Khan from Star Trek the Two?
Yes, that's who I'm talking about. I just want to yell, Khan!
Anyway, CitizenCon is actually, they show off like their biggest shit, right? And that's, like I said, in a couple weeks here. And Brandon, what are you looking at? He's just whispering what? Con. And I'm excited for it because they're probably going to announce, you know, 2.6, which is like the latest update that adds an basically builds an FPS game inside of it, where instead of playing like the universe mode, you can just go shoot each other for fun.
There's one thing I ever wanted with my dogfighting space game. It's first-person shooter.
Well, that's the thing. It's not a dogfighting space game. It's just a game where you can dogfight. And
it was space. Originally.
It's a whatever you want it to be game.
That's basically it. Yeah. Because like from the beginning, I was like, I'm not going to fight anybody. I'm just going to fucking move cargo and smuggle things illegally from planet to planet.
Star Citizen. Dogfighting.
That's true. How are you going to do that without dogfighting?
Well, fucking Firefly doesn't. They don't firefight. They don't have dogfights in Serenity. They don't even have fucking
they
guns.
They don't have fireflies. But yeah, they do.
There's no guns.
That
on
is
the
a cargo
Serenity.
Ship, Brandon. They stated in like the first episode.
And every other fucking episode. There's no guns.
But I mean, they state the fact that there's no guns on it when Wash comes up to that bar and he's like, "Damn, yokels don't realize this ship's got no guns on it."
Yeah, that was like the fourth episode, but yeah.
So, okay, yeah, you're right. It was the fourth episode.
But
can we base all further conversations about this on the movie? Because I never watched the TV show.
You should do that as soon as we get done talking.
I can't.
I gotta watch Jason's review first.
I can't be on this podcast anymore. I can't do it.
Multitask. That's it. Yeah, Nerd Play's done. Jason and I are going to start our new podcast called Serena Dudes, and we're just going to talk about we're going to talk about Firefly comics, TV show, and movie lore.
You know, you could do that separate. We don't have to quit this podcast.
We don't even have time to do this podcast.
Can we make a podcast called Serena Dudes?
It's a really great name, actually. Procure that domain.
I'm on board with it. I might watch this TV show just
to be part of it.
But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to it because there's going to be like they always have big sales during it. And if you guys watched the Gamescom's footage, which I'm going to just go ahead and say you didn't, even though I told you to watch it multiple times, it's like where they're at now is amazing. Like you can fly to planets, meet up with NPCs, get mission, land on the planet, talk to them, get missions from them, then go out and do missions. Like in that one, they have to go explore a derelict ship that's been like, you know, half blown up, floating in space, find some cargo on it. Or they find the black box and they find this really cool space motorcycle, and then the guy who gives them the mission is like, "Great, you know that cargo is down on the moon though at the pirate space. If you want to get it," so they fly down there, blow up a fucking or fight like some land vehicles because they're gonna add land vehicles to the game too, obviously. Then get out of their ship, go fight the pirates in their base, kill them all, and then they go to take the cargo. And the guy who gave them the quest shows up like, double crossed.
Shit.
And watch the footage, Jason. Brandon, don't, because he's a cynic who hates all video games.
I did watch it. You sent that to me a long, long time ago, and it was a really long video. And guess what? I watched the whole thing.
Did you really? I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
I watched that video of them entering the atmosphere of that one planet. So dang, that's something,
good work,
right?
Brandon. You missed out because when they landed, they played fantasy football.
What?
Yeah.
That is how we're going to get Brandon to do everything from now on. It's like, oh my God, Brandon, there are some sweet, sweet tips on trades on this video. You gotta watch.
You gotta check it out, bro. But they're like in the middle of it somewhere, you know. So you have to watch the whole video to find it.
Yeah. So what? It's coming.
All right.
Here we come.
He's like, I guess I'll
do
what it.
I gotta do.
Do you play fantasy basketball too?
Yeah.
God, you're fucking lame. Is there even like a difference between basketball players? This guy shoots the hoops. What's that guy do? He also shoots hoops.
Obviously, cool. There's a difference.
That's like saying, is there a difference between like marathon runners?
That's like saying, basically what you said is...
Never mind, I take that back.
Basically, Dan, what you just said is there a difference between Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant? What's the difference? There? What's the difference?
Kobe better?
Well, that's a really poor... Yeah, like
Kobe Bryant's the new Michael Jordan.
Those are two very similar players, but that's like saying there's no difference between Allen Iverson and Shaquille O'Neal.
Okay, you know what? That means literally nothing to me.
How about Muggsy Bogues?
What?
And
does Allen Iverson have a movie about being a genie?
No, what about
what about a movie about being a metal cyborg?
Does he have a video game?
No.
Where he plays Kung Fu? What does he do? Icy Hot commercials?
Who doesn't do Icy Hot commercials these days? I have an Icy Hot commercial.
Does he do
Icy Hot? Apply directly to the Icy Hot. That's how it goes. It's a good commercial.
That's head on.
Very good, Jason.
I don't even know. How did we get here?
I don't know. Oh, because we were talking about Wing Commander.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Well, that was fun.
We are really drowning over here, guys. This is not good.
Anyway.
Are we in the et cetera portion of our podcast?
Basically, yeah. Well, I want to talk about the new TV seasons are starting.
Yes.
And a few of my favorites are coming back this week. One of them primarily being Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Brandon, you ever watch Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
No.
Brandon doesn't do anything.
What
Brandon
do you watch? Well, no, Brandon's watching TV for 80% of his fucking free time. So I know because my Xbox tells me. Like, well, actually, at this point, when he shows up in my friends list, it says still fucking watching TV. Like, are you okay?
Brandon has to watch all the football games and the baseball games.
You don't watch fucking football and baseball games when you play fantasy. You just fucking check the stats. You don't need to fucking watch the game.
You don't have to, but I like to watch.
Here you go. See? Case in point.
Case closed. This motherfucker right here.
Yeah.
So what do you watch then, for real? I want to know, like, what real TV you watch.
Oh, very little.
Is it because is it because they have cuss words and violence in them?
Say that again.
Is it because they have cuss words and violence in them?
Oh, you know, that's sure. Let's say that's what it is. But it's really just that I don't know. I just don't care that much.
All right, well, then you can check out, because me and Jason are going to talk about some good fucking TV.
I've got a TV. You know what? I've got a TV show to talk about that's coming.
What is it? Let's hear it. No, I want to hear it. I want to go straight to you.
Coming on in 1 week.
What is it? The MLB playoffs?
No, it's not. It's actually dark. A half-hour situational comedy.
Is it called Brooklyn Nine-Nine?
No.
Is it called The Good Place?
Close, though. I've only watched bits and pieces of Brooklyn Nine-Nine. I heard it's good.
It's really funny. Like, I'm surprised how funny it is.
It got so much better. The first season, I watched the pilot episode, and I was like, this sucks. And then I gave it a chance.
Was that because I yelled at you about how it doesn't suck and you're stupid?
Yeah, and then I watched the next three episodes, and they sucked. And then I accidentally watched a later episode, and it was really fucking funny.
So what's your show, Brandon?
I want to watch The Last Man on Earth.
Oh, I love that show.
With Will Forte? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's coming back. That show started off like you had to make yourself watch it almost. Like when it first came out, like, I know it's going to pay off.
There was a lot of setup, that's for sure. I thought they did a pretty decent job of handling it.
He was so unlikable.
There were some slow moments. Yeah, that was part of the problem. Really, the first season, they did that to him, and I think that's why they started walking that back quite a bit.
They went too
season.
Far with it, is the thing. You know, it got to the point where you're just like, man, fuck him.
Yeah,
he's a shitbag. Yeah. Jason, do you ever watch it?
I've seen a couple episodes here and there. I haven't watched a lot of it, though, no.
Imagine Gilmore Girls, but funny with good acting and a completely different story.
Yeah.
And
I just wanted to talk shit about Gilmore Girls, that's all.
I'm like, I've never seen Gilmore Girls, so I don't know I really think
you guys, if you gave it a chance, you would really appreciate it.
I've watched a lot of episodes of that show, and I just
with all the pop culture references, you would really appreciate. I feel like you would appreciate it. Brandon probably wouldn't because apparently he's just not pop cultured.
Yeah,
is
he's
he
definitely
being sarcastic?
I can't tell. Honestly, this show sucks. But
you'll never know.
There is a show coming out that I'm Agents hoping is really good. No. I mean, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I just assume will be mediocre and I'll love it.
Yeah.
Okay. Because that's how it is every season. But actually, it was pretty good.
That last season, man, was intense.
Season two. It was season two, season, right? Two or
season
three.
Season three. It was season three, right?
I don't fucking remember. All I know is it was good.
They went through that portal and then, I don't know.
Dude, that was awesome.
Yeah, it got last season was really good. The season before that was really good. This season's going to have Ghost Rider.
Yeah.
Driving a fucking car. Hello. What the fuck kind of Ghost Rider are they talking about here? He was like driving a ghost lowrider.
Decision making.
Oh my god, I just made that up off the top of my head and Brandon talked over it, but it was so fucking good. I'm assuming you heard it, Jason, right?
The ghost lowrider?
Yes, thank you.
When he hits the horn, it goes.
That's absolutely what it does, yeah. And the devil comes out. But I'm excited for that, but no, there's a new show starting, Lethal Weapon.
Oh, yeah.
Have you guys seen anything about this? I had not even heard of it. It blindsided me today.
It blindsided me yesterday. I saw a brief, like, 15-second spot for it on television, and I was like, what? What is this? WTF, mate. What is this?
Uh-oh. Variety titled it Lethal Weapon MacGyver TV when remakes go wrong or some shit like that. Hold on, I got
it looked, I don't even know, just why can't they leave it alone? If it's not Mel Gibson and Danny Glover, I don't want to watch it.
I don't give a fuck about that. I just, if it has the same mouth feel as the movies, then I will be absolutely okay with it, because
Dan's all about the mouth feel.
I'm all about mouth feel. That's how I rate everything. But If it has like the same feeling to it as the movies, like the same back and forth, the same humor,
right?
Then I love it. I hope it is good. That's, I'm just saying, I hope it's good.
Well, I hope everything is good, but guess what? We don't live in that world.
Jeez, this fucking guy, what a cynic! I'm gonna give it the benefit of the doubt.
Now I sound like me,
and that's not a compliment.
No, it absolutely was not.
All right, you guys got anything else you really want to talk about?
Yeah, what about Gotham? You left that one out.
Oh, fuck, you're right. Oh, my God. How did I forget?
That started the night. We missed it.
Well, I'm probably going to watch it on Hulu anyway because I don't have my antenna hooked up. Yeah, I said antenna. What of it?
I got one. It's on top of my house.
Brandon's like, currently. I have the X1 box. All right. Brandon, did you see what they added to the X1 box?
No.
What season of Gotham is this? Three?
Yeah.
Netflix.
What'd they add to the X1?
Netflix.
What? Oh. That's why I hooked up my Xbox.
That's why my PS3 still hooked up in my bedroom.
But no,
so
they...
So I can tell, hey, Cortana.
Brandon, that's, or Jason, that's not the... You don't have a fucking X1 box.
I said, that's why my PS3 is still in my bedroom.
Yeah, my point is
that... For Netflix.
Yeah, but you... You're not relevant. It's like being like, hey, Brandon, did you hear that this specific car that you drive has an upgrade? And you're like, yeah. That's why I don't have one of those.
Nope. You don't have an analogy for that. It doesn't work. You said
my
Netflix.
My analogy is along with your input on that fucking situation.
Why would it matter? If there's Netflix on something, why would it matter? You're talking about having Netflix on something. I'm talking about having Netflix on something.
Okay. You know what? We'll just go with
it. Did you know that they're remaking the, or Netflix. They're also making the movie Frequency into a series on the CW?
Oh, I did see that. Did you also know they're remaking Westworld into a series on HBO? And that actually looks fucking tight.
What?
Westworld.
You just found out about the Westworld thing? They've been like talking about that for months. Like since Game of Thrones was on.
I just got HBO Go.
Oh, so. Guys, should I be watching Son of Zorn? That's what I really want.
I kind of want to check that out.
I kind of want to also. I
what
do.
What the fuck
yeah.
is Frequency?
It was a movie with Jim Caviezel where he like talked to his dad back in time.
Oh my
CD
fucking
radio.
God! They made a TV show. No, the TV show is not connected to that. Is it really?
It can't be. How could they? No. How could they make an entire series based on that premise? There's no way.
There's no fucking way.
It's going to be like Ghost Rider.
Wait. In 2016, NYPD Detective Raimi Sullivan discovers that she is able to speak to her deceased father, Frank Sullivan, in 1996 via his old ham radio. Her attempts to save his life trigger the butterfly effect, changing the present in unforeseen ways. To fix the damage, she must work with her father across time to solve a decades-old murder case. How the fuck is solving the decades-old murder case going to fix... What the fuck? Why are there two Brandons?
Why are there two Brandons? What happened? Oh my God!
My computer died.
His computer died.
Oh,
voice quality is real good. This sounds fucking stupid, like everything else on the CW. Are you kidding me with this shit? I love how she's like, "Oh, there's a butterfly effect, and it's fucking up the future. We have to fix it by solving a murder case."
You know what that sounds like with that, like going back and talking to. Oh yeah, but it sounds like going back and solving things. It sounds like the premise for Ghost Rider. Like that show Ghost Rider. Do you remember that?
Rally J?
Yeah. Yes, actually, Rally J.
I kind of feel like you're messing with me now.
You don't remember that show? Ghost Rider. Whirr. That was a great show when you were young. As an adult, though, probably don't watch it.
Right, that's what I did frequency.
How do you see the, what's the connection? Brandon, you've probably seen it.
They like get those messages from Ghost Rider to like do those things and fix the stuff that's going on or how to like solve the mystery.
Did they really? Yeah, but they weren't like solving murder mysteries. They were solving the mystery of like where did Jay put my fucking teddy bear?
That's like solving the mystery of who cut the crust off my PB&J.
who took my PB&J? Mine had no crusts.
Right. But I'm saying it's like an adult-themed version of that.
Yeah, sure. That's actually how it's going to work. She's going to write Rally J, and then they're going to meet at Jamal's house. Oh, fuck. Jose's, because Jamal's the name of the character from Ghost Rider. Why do I remember that?
I'm embarrassed. I don't know why you remember
What's
that.
What's the theme for this month's Gotham?
This month?
Or this season? I don't know. Last scenes was like here. Last month, last God fuck.
Stop
last
saying
season
that.
Was heroes or villains? Rise of the Villains or whatever.
Yes.
Do we have one for this one?
We didn't get Rise of the Villains until like halfway through the season.
No, it was called that from the beginning. But then in the beginning, it was like covered in ice, and then they stopped covering it in ice.
Okay, you're right.
I think I remember it was called like Heroes Will. Heroes Will Fall? Something like that. Yeah, and like Jim was saying, like, I am not a cop or whatever the fuck. I don't know. Are you excited for Gotham?
I'm so excited for Gotham.
I feel like that show's gotten so much better since since when it first came out.
They are apparently doing some new things with Poison Ivy and not making her that contrived little girl whose
little
name
Irish
is Ivy.
Girl.
Yeah. They're actually going to do something different with her.
That's
so
good.
Yeah, I'm very pleased about that.
I'm just worried they're getting a little ahead of themselves. I mean, I know they're changing the canon or whatever, but I'm worried they're getting like ahead of themselves, you know?
Well, I mean, Bruce he's not super young. He's like 14, almost a teenager. 15? Yeah, or he is a teenager. So I mean, it's not like there's that many years away from him being able to become
Batman.
He's like
28 when he becomes Batman, doesn't he?
Is he that old? I thought he was younger than that.
He explores the whole fucking world.
Oh, yeah.
Learns kung fu in, like, fucking the Southeast Asia or some shit.
That's, yeah.
Lives
that's
in the
true.
Middle East.
I want to know now, when does Bruce Wayne become Batman?
It doesn't even fucking matter, because this is not Bruce Wayne and Batman that we grew up with and love and all that shit. This is, like, different, weird, made-up, you know, continuity.
Okay.
Where this fucking shitty detective who is technically like an anti-hero, almost a bad guy, is now a good guy, hanging out with Jim Gordon. You know, being pals.
Has he met Dick Grayson yet in the show?
No, because Dick Grayson's like fucking a zygote or like a sperm in a nutsack at this point in his life.
Yeah, Dick Grayson is in a flash in the pan.
Dick, well, I mean, like, Robin was like, okay, so when Batman was like a full-grown man, Robin was like a fucking tween.
Yeah. Which is why it was so weird for them to be hanging out.
Or at least him to not be wearing pants.
Right. It was not
I'm just going to wear Spanx, Bruce. I don't know if that's a good idea, Dick. Could you maybe put on some pants? Nah, I can't breathe. You know, I got to be free.
Like, you know, Dick, people might get the wrong idea if you're running around next to me in that very bright colored outfit with those booty shorts on. Ah, it's cool. Check it out. Check it out, Bruce.
I mean, when you think about it, Bruce, I'm pretty sure they're going to be more worried about the fact that you're letting me jump off skyscrapers and fight supervillain murderers, but whatever.
look how much room I got in these shorts, Bruce. Oh my God, Dick, just stop.
It feels like there's nothing there at all.
Stupid, sexy Robin. Stupid, sexy Grayson.
All right.
Was he auditioning for a condom commercial?
Say what?
What?
Anyway,
can you guys hear me at all?
Yeah, I can now.
A little bit. You're cutting in and out pretty bad. But I'm just going to call it anyway.
I think this ship is sunk.
It's so off the rails at this point.
Ship has sunk, guys.
I will say this. I'm pretty excited. I splurged this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
And bought an Oculus Rift virtual reality headset.
Oh, yeah.
And it arrived
tomorrow. Is that really tomorrow? It really is going to be there tomorrow.
Yeah. According to Oops, Brown does me right, or whatever the fuck their slogan is.
Oh, yeah, it does.
But no, according to UPS, it'll arrive tomorrow around... Are we talking about iPhones and Android phones again? But according to UPS, it'll show up tomorrow, and I'm going to, you know, puke a lot until I get used to it. And but we're probably gonna have a lot of new material,
streams,
footage. Yeah, streams. I'm gonna figure out how to stream. I'm excited too. The same week as CitizenCon is Oculus Connect 3, which is another little, you know, convention thingy, starting I think October 5th. And they're gonna announce the Oculus Touch there, which are the controllers that you hold in your hands, so you can actually like interact with this like, you know, virtual world. And I'm actually really, really fucking excited to see what they announced there. I was actually considering waiting until that and seeing if they had like a bundle that came with all of it in one kit, you know, for like $800.
Yeah.
But then you got too excited.
Well, I was talking to people about it on Reddit, and they were like, you know, once they announce the Touch, they're probably going to like be sold out for the rest of the year. Like, because... Even now, this thing came out in like what, March of this year, I think.
The Oculus.
Yeah, I think it was.
Yeah.
And then the Vive came out like of November last year, and then the Oculus came out of March of this year, and was completely sold out for a long time. I mean, before I moved here, so like late July or whatever, I was looking at them on their website, and it was like buy now to get one in September, and it was like, oh, great.
I'm so surprised that it's not still sold out.
Well, I think they've like tripled production, you know? I mean, I know with the Touch, they're saying that we're not going to have that problem again. It's not going to happen again, you know? But I think they're underestimating it, because supposedly everyone who pre-ordered a Rift is automatically pre-ordered for a Touch if they want one. And you know everyone who has a Rift is going to want to get the Touch, because why the fuck would you have a VR headset and you can't have like the hand controls too? That's gonna, right. That's like half of it.
That would be such a pain in the ass to have to use your keyboard and mouse and have a VR.
Well, I'm going to play a lot of games that way, because they have a lot. They have experiences that are designed for the controller. It comes with one of these, an Xbox One controller comes in the box with the wireless adapter. I'm so fucking psyched about that, honestly. It comes with that. It comes with a remote, because they have some experiences. Like they have this Obama thing where you go to national parks with Obama, and he's like talking to you, and it's like video and shit, but you can like look all around the national parks or whatever. And like, you only need a remote for that. You don't need like a full on controller. And then they're going to have the Touch, which will have things designed for that too. And I'm wondering even if it's going to work with Xbox Play Anywhere, because supposedly the Scorpio will work with the Oculus Rift. That's like the ongoing theory, that because there's a partnership between Oculus and Microsoft already. You know, that's why it comes with the Microsoft Xbox One controller. So everyone's saying that, you know, oh, the Scorpio's going to do VR. The Scorpio's going to do VR. Microsoft aren't going to make their own fucking headset. You're just going to plug your Oculus Rift into the Scorpio.
That is the prevailing rumor.
Yeah, so I'm, like, wondering, like, if that'd be awesome if I play anywhere games. I could like do it in the living room or do it in here, you know, just whatever, have fun.
So is Microsoft just making applications for VR? Because remember that whole thing we watched? The Microsoft thing where they were showing all those different like VR simulations and you put your headset on and like you're looking at different stuff.
That wasn't VR. That was augmented reality for the HoloLens. And that's a
that's
different
thing. That's what it was, the HoloLens. I'm sorry. I was...
The
okay,
HoloLens
yeah.
isn't like a headset in the same thought, you know? Like this is like head track or motion tracking, space tracking throughout the room.
Okay.
With like lenses or screens mounted to your face. The
That was AR. Okay.
Yeah, the HoloLens is like a $3,000 computer you wear on your head. and it's fucking amazing. If it had a wider field of view,
I'm holding out for that.
That thing is actually tight. I mean, like, I've seen some of the stuff that they've been doing with it, and it's really cool, but it's not, I mean, I don't fucking got $3,000, do you? To just, like, throw away on something like that?
I don't even have $75 for a new video card.
The field of view is like, you know, it sounds like horrible when you say it that way, because the card costs a lot more than that.
I know.
But it's like holding, it's like the size of a playing card or something like that, your field of view, so... I don't know. I'm just really excited to try it out, man. Like, they have a bunch of free shit on the store. They have a sale that ends tomorrow. Like, I don't know if tonight's the last night or if tomorrow. I hope it's tomorrow's last day so I can put it on and be like, this is cool. I'm going to buy a bunch of these games while they're still on sale. But this is so lame. But I was really excited to find out that the Windows 10 Minecraft works with it.
Nice.
I know it sounds stupid, but I'm really excited for VR Minecraft.
That's like one of the reasons I wanted to get it is for VR Minecraft.
Really?
It's like that was the only game I was like, this would be the best thing in VR. And I don't feel like it would make me sick as much as something like GTA would make me sick if I were playing it in VR.
Well, the reason you get sick is because of the locomotion. Like you're moving, your brain thinks you're moving, but your body isn't. So you're like,
right.
But they say you outgrow that. Most people outgrow it. There's like a small percentage of people that will never get over it, but this is like the same thing as like people who get seasick and shit.
Yeah, people that couldn't go see Cloverfield.
Yeah. But they say like if you're not one of those, like you might initially be like, but you'll get over it like after using it a few times, you know. I'm looking forward to it. I think I'm going to take it home on Christmas and let my family experience it. Maybe Jason, maybe instead of doing our trade-off in Huntley, you guys should come here and then you can play it.
You know what? I think that might be in order, and maybe you can cook for me and Kate.
Yeah, maybe I can. What the fuck kind of...
Hey, I'm just gonna come play it.
Brandon, you can come over too, but don't bring Brittany.
Just you.
Yeah, just you.
Can't promise anything.
And Sean. I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
I'm going to cut that part. All right. anyway, that's it for this week, I think, unless you guys have anything else you want to say.
I don't. We're dead.
We're completely off the rails.
We're completely dead.
Yeah, I'm Dan. You can find me on Twitter at Dan Crum.
I'm Jason. You can find me on Twitter at Jason Frummer.
And I'm Brandon. You can find me on Twitter at Nimzels, but I don't really tweet that much.
Yeah, you know what? Maybe you should just get on it, dude.
Just seriously, Joe, just pull the trigger, man.
You have plenty of opinions, and I know you get bored of shit during your downtime at work.
I do.
You could be tweeting.
You could be tweeting all kinds of crazy, embarrassing, offensive shit.
Yeah, you could be tweeting at Dan and I.
I've really got to work on a lot of fantasy trades, though, right now. I'm wheeling and dealing. Oh,
Jesus. All right, I'm done.
Okay,
I'm out of here.
That's it. We'll see you guys next week. Thanks for listening. Bye.
Bye.